Mark Piet was appointed to lead the group. He knew that even though they had now criminalized international bribery, the practice was not going away.
Companies found themselves in a very awkward situation. Suddenly, the element of risk rose. And there's a double risk. On the one hand, you might be caught. On the other hand, you might lose out because your competitors are not playing game.
Your competitors are continuing to bribe.
Right.
That's what this man told us he kept doing for one of Germany's largest companies, the Siemens Corporation, after the anti-bribery treaty was signed.
Paying bribes was customary in nearly all business units of Siemens.
Reinhard Sikacek was in charge of part of Siemens' massive billion-dollar international bribery operations.
I was a true Siemens man for sure. I was known as the keeper of the slush funds. We all knew what we were doing was illegal.
To avoid getting caught, Siemens used secret bank accounts in places like Switzerland and front companies, plus the age-old method, cash.
For €1 million, you don't need a big suitcase because the bills aren't very big. A briefcase is enough. €200,000 isn't so much that you couldn't carry it in your coat pocket.